Google has recently announced the limited public rollout of its new chatbot, Bard, which is a competitor to OpenAI's ChatGPT and Microsoft's Bing chatbot. Users in the US and UK can join a waitlist to access the chatbot. Bard is an early experiment that will let you to collaborate with generative AI, and is based on Google's own language model. Users can ask Bard questions and refine answers with follow-up queries, with the chatbot generating responses using reinforcement learning from human feedback. Google explained that Bard would work particularly well for Nora queries, which are questions to which there's no one right answer. However, as with all conversational AI, there are concerns around accuracy, sources of information, and ethical considerations. Google also warned users that Bard may display inaccurate or offensive information that may not represent Google's views. Bard uses generative artificial intelligence to create new content from input prompts, is a competitor to OpenAI's ChatGPT. Bard is a standalone application that complements Google Search and is currently in a limited public rollout in the United States and the United Kingdom, with plans to expand to more countries and more languages. Like ChatGPT and GPT-4, Bard uses reinforcement learning to improve its responses and generate more human-like conversations. Microsoft has also added AI-generated visuals powered by OpenAI's DALL-E to its search engine, demonstrating the trend of tech companies leveraging generative AI to create advanced and personalized user experiences. Unlike Microsoft's Bing chatbot, Bard does not have footnotes with web sources. However, users can rate answers with a thumbs up or thumbs down and view more answers for the same query. Bard is a standalone product from Google's search engine, and users cannot interact with Bard from the search results. The limited release of Bard is the first step of a long process, and it remains to be seen how regulators and content creators will respond to Google's new product. Generative AI is a category of artificial intelligence algorithms that create new content, such as images, text, and audio, based on the data they have been trained on. This is achieved using generative adversarial networks, GANs, which consist of a generator and discriminator neural network. The generator creates new data and improves its outputs based on feedback from the discriminator until it generates content that is indistinguishable from real data. Generative AI has a wide range of applications, such as creating new images based on existing ones, writing news articles and poetry, generating new music tracks and voice acting, and creating video games, movies, and TV shows. Generative AI can also be used to translate text from one language to another. Despite concerns that generative AI and automation will lead to job displacement and unemployment, it has the potential to positively impact the job market by automating repetitive and time-consuming tasks and allowing humans to focus on more creative and value-adding work. It can also disrupt several industries, including advertising, art and design, and entertainment, by making it easier for companies and content creators to reach new audiences and generate new ideas and concepts. Overall, while there are valid concerns about the impact of AI on the job market, there are also many potential benefits that could positively impact workers and the economy. The launch of Bard is an early experiment that allows users in the US and the UK to collaborate with generative AI. The purpose of Bard is to boost productivity, accelerate ideas, and fuel curiosity. Users can ask Bard for tips to achieve goals such as reading more books, explanations of complex topics like quantum physics, or inspiration for creative projects like outlining a blog post. Bard allows users to interact with a generative AI powered by a large language model, LLM, which is a prediction engine that selects words likely to come next to generate responses to prompts. It is grounded in Google's understanding of quality information, but LLMs have faults such as real-world biases and the potential to provide inaccurate or false information. Bard addresses this by giving users the choice of multiple drafts of its response and the option to try again. It is designed as a complementary experience to Google Search, and users can easily visit Search to check Bard's responses or explore sources across the web. Google plans to integrate LLMs more deeply into search in future. Google has plans to continue to improve Bard and add capabilities, including coding, more languages, and multimodal experiences, and invites users to sign up for the experiment at bard.google.com to provide feedback and help Bard get better. Generative AI technology, specifically ChatGPT-4, has the potential to transform the internet search business and numerous professions. Microsoft has invested at least $1 billion in OpenAI and integrated AI chatbot tech into its Bing browser. These machine learning systems have the ability to converse, readable text on demand, and produce novel images and videos based on what they've learned from a vast database of digital books and online text. GPT-4, in particular, exhibits human-level performance and can handle more nuanced instructions than its predecessor, GPT-3.5. Despite its imperfections, it is seen as a commodity tool that could be used on a daily basis. As Mirella Lopata, professor of natural language processing at the University of Edinburgh, said, with GPT-4, we are one step closer to life imitating art. Now, with the advent of Bard, the competition between the AI giants will increase. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel for more such videos.